Marcel Rohner is the president of the Swiss Bankers Association since last September. Today I'm speaking with him to better understand his priorities for this coming year of 2022. I'm Tanya König and welcome to finance.swiss. When taking office of the Swiss Bankers Association, you communicated a clear goal. You want to ensure that the Swiss financial center grows. How can we achieve this?
When we look at this financial center and ask ourselves, how does it grow? Then one is like a macroeconomic point of view and say, we do grow when the Swiss economy grows. We do grow when we branch out into new fields and businesses and services. We also grow if we export more of our services to the rest of the world, which is an important part. So when we look at these three things, we have to ask ourselves, what can location policy contribute to create an environment which fosters growth? And there are a number of aspects. One aspect is that we need to ensure that we operate in a highly competitive environment, because a highly competitive environment is an environment which fosters innovation, and innovation is a driver of growth according to the three areas I said before. We can export more, we can do more business within Switzerland. So this is an important part. And this means that we should have as low entry barriers into our industry as possible, which means we need a proportionate regulation, but we need also to be open to new services such as open banking, where we have a breakup of a value chain, which clearly increases competition, makes life more challenging also for banks, but ultimately contributes to a competitive environment.
There is more regulation. Are these for Swiss banks still proportionate if you think about growth?
Well, you clearly would have slightly diverging views from those banks who are, by their business model, very active internationally. These are obviously our large banks, which have a very global and complex business model, but also all the asset managers and all the private banks which serve client base all around the world. For a bank which is exclusively active in the domestic market, one or the other part of the regulation might look slightly over the top or too much of a burden, which is why our regulator has actually introduced a differentiating regulatory regime within Switzerland, whilst at the same time ensuring that we have obviously one consistent regulation for our financial market in Switzerland. We are, after all, one financial center here and not two of them. And this is a balance which we always have to strike. Being seen as equivalent, as serious, as reliable from the outside, but also reasonable with the perspective of what the goal of a regulation is in its application internally, that's a continuous challenge which I think we have so far met quite well.
Switzerland has no stock exchange equivalents with its neighbor, the European Union. How does the Swiss Financial Center deal with that?
Well, I think we have actually dealt quite well with it. Our government has basically reacted to the non-acknowledgement of equivalence by the EU by reciprocating the whole thing and say, well, if we can't, you can't either. And in the end, I think that was only a fair and appropriate reaction. And it ultimately led to the fact that the volumes even went up. At the time, insofar, we could cope with that very well, although we still think that this decision was entirely political. We understand that the equivalence has actually already been accepted and agreed by all the member states. It was a last-minute decision in the context of broader negotiation not to grant this equivalence to Switzerland, which we regret, and hopefully it will be revised at some point in time in the future. And we think when we look at our infrastructure, at our regulations around the exchange, this is obviously not really distinguishable in any material sense from what's going on in the European Union.
And what might other financial centers outside the EU play? What role might they play here in Switzerland?
There are two, three other places in the world which do a lot of the same business as we do here in Switzerland. First and foremost, it's the UK. It's the largest asset management place in the world. For institutional asset managers, it's also the largest offshore financial center in the world. So it's, in a sense, a competitor. But as always, with our friendly competitors, they have the same interest towards the rest of the world as we have. But I think, particularly in the UK, they also share very much the same principles and views on market access. And that's why our government is in a very intense equivalence negotiation phase with the UK. And this will be an important proof of concept. It will grant us mutual market access. And as always, this increases competition, but this will ultimately be beneficial for both of us in the long term. Singapore is another center which has essentially a very similar business model as Switzerland, and I could imagine that a closer cooperation would make a lot of sense with such a financial center as well.
The industry is also facing massive technological shifts. Digitalization is a challenge. Is a Swiss financial center and the banks, are they well prepared for this?
I think we are. To begin with, the Swiss financial infrastructure is probably one of the most highly developed in the world. We have a super fast, super reliable payment system infrastructure. We have a fully integrated exchange. The banks have been on technological innovation path for the last 30 years. So in that sense, digitalization is not something entirely new. There are just new opportunities emerging now because the infrastructure is so much more powerful. The internet and everything which comes with it, AI, big data, all the opportunities and possibilities which emerge from these new developments and innovations create opportunities for new competitors. They also create opportunities for the banks. The way a bank can interact with a client today are obviously much more flexible than it was like 30 years ago. The virtual office, video interaction with portfolio analysis on the side is an example. A bank can serve the customers much better. But there are also other things, like I have addressed open banking, a split of the value chain, certain competitors which engage in a very specific field of the value chain, be it reporting, be it accounting, be it client identification, you name it. And then this offers the banks opportunities to outsource certain parts of the value chain. So clearly, of the value chain, clearly, these innovative steps, they create business opportunities much more than they are a threat. At the same time, of course, having these neobanks coming in, such as Revolut, N26, creates new competition, and it forces the incumbents to react to these challenges by offering their services in a more client-friendly way.
The Swiss Federal Councillor wants the Swiss Financial Center to become the greenest and most sustainable in the world, to make a clear contribution to society and the environment, and to be a credible location for investors. So what does this mean for banks?
For us banks, this is primarily an opportunity, but it's also a commitment for us. The demand comes from all our clients, both internationally and domestically, from institutional clients and private clients. They do want to invest their assets in a sustainable way. They want to make sure that they are invested in a way which is consistent with their values or with their sustainability objectives. And that's where I see a bright future for the financial center. Imagine that more and more people globally realize that this is the place where you have the broadest offering of sustainability products, where you have the easiest access to very specific ways on how you want to invest in a sustainable basis, where you find the experts who can advise you with knowledge and competence on investing in a sustainable way, then this financial center will grow. It will grow because more and more funds globally flow into Switzerland and are invested in a meaningful, sustainable way. And this is where we see our biggest contribution.
Great, and all the best with that. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.